Bro, Mickey Mouse going in. What's up, everybody? It's your favorite water thought, Patrick CC, reminding you to stay hydrated. I'm sure a lot of you have heard about 645 AR recently, and a lot of you wanted my opinion on the SQUEAK-Style Rapper from Atlanta. Before we dive real deep into it, let's talk about this For The Trap record. He posted a video clip of this song on his Twitter and it amassed like 4 or 5 million views. Since then, the Twitter account that he posted that on got suspended because it blew up so fast that Twitter actually thought that he was like some sort of spam or something. That's true virality. I don't really know why that would happen. But regardless, he posted the video again on his new Twitter page and it didn't get as many views, but is still growing quite a bit. And on that same day that he made the new post on Twitter, DJ Academics actually posted it on his Instagram page. I think he also posted it on his Twitter. Yeah, he did post it on his Twitter. He said, "Hottest in the streets right now. Since mad labels and A&Rs be following me, if y'all don't sign this man by the time I wake up, y'all dumb. This shit going crazy in the streets right now." Now, of course, a lot of people are asking, why? Why the squeak voice? What happened? What led you to this? Well, he posted a little video on social media showing how it all came to be. I like how he plays into the meme rather than trying to pretend like, like people shouldn't be memeing it or he doesn't get pissed off or whatever, which would be really just weird. But he plays into the meme and I like that about him. Now this song, For The Trap, is for sure the hardest that he has gone with the squeak style, but let's back it up a little bit and see how this all kind of evolved. Let's go to his SoundCloud page and just go back in time. We'll start with the song Sip. All the tech I be fed up. These niggas don't want me. These niggas don't want none. Hood rich, hood rich. Shit, boy, I do that shit for fun. I'm not gonna show you the whole song, but you can trust me that there is no squeaking in that song. And this is over a year ago, could be closer to 2 years, but SoundCloud sucks. Should just tell you the date that it was released. Don't know why they haven't implemented that. It was actually this next song called Crack, where he implemented, as far as we know, the first squeak style. I want the money, I want the money, so go get the money. Pack stick like honey, I can go broke, I ain't no dummy. They want that crack, so I'll give them that cut. Going out bad, I ain't going like that. And that was really his only part in the song. I'm guessing that's the hook. Yeah, I think that's the hook. But he mixed it. He mixed the squeak style with, I guess you could say, more of his natural voice. Also, if you look at the video on YouTube, this song was actually promoted about 6 months later by Lil Tecca. Not really sure how. I'm presuming that he probably just put it on his Instagram story. But again, this was also people's first indication that 645 AR is lit. But I mean, 5-6 months ago is actually way before he sort of went viral, and none of these vlogs or popular news outlets or whatever we're talking about him. So Tecca was early. We have the song Wham Bam. Again, just a few bars with the squeak style, then he went to a more normal voice, I guess. I mean, anything compared to the squeak sounds normal. Not as highly produced, not as executed as well, but we're working our way up. But when he dropped Bible and a K, that's when things started to shake up a little bit. I mean, you're kind of just hating if you don't think that that goes hard. Basically, after a Bible and a K, all of the songs pretty much use the squeak flow in almost the entirety of the track. There are a few where he doesn't do it as much, and I think that maybe there are a couple where he doesn't do it at all, but for the most part, I think after he dropped that song, he was like, all right, this is working, people like this, it's controversial, people are going crazy, let me just keep doing it. And of course, they all led up to For The Trap, which is the slap of the century. I guess what makes Florida trap so appealing is the absolute ridiculousness of it, which is pretty obvious because you can't really hear what he's saying. Even if you look at the lyrics side by side with the song, still even kind of hard to make it out. But oddly enough, you can feel the emotion there. The whole production, the vibe that it gives off really sounds like a street record, as silly as that sounds. It actually is a vibe. And obviously the intent of the song is not necessarily to relate to the lyrics, it's more so to feel the emotion, even at a really, really high pitch. Also, did you really think I was gonna make this video and not look at the comments? Mom, can we get Playboy Cardi? Mom, no, we have Playboy Cardi at home. Playboy Cardi at home. Oh, when he said, different. The thing about this song and songs, you just can't hit that flow. You can't sing this in the car. You could try. That legitimately hurt trying to do that. Cardi got 24 hours to respond to this, or he gonna have to hand over the crown. It's kind of facts. Cardi, where you at? You're awfully silent during these tough hours with 6:45 AR. Damn, not gonna lie, hate him or love him, this mosquito straight spitting facts, no cap. I can't hear any lyrics, but my dogs are going crazy. If you don't know, dogs can hear really, really, really intensely high pitches that humans can't hear. So the intent of the joke is that he can't really hear it, but the dogs can hear it, and the dogs can hear it. Literally had to come here from Twitter to make sure I wasn't watching an edit. It's facts. When you listen to it, you're like, this can't actually be the song that he's putting out and promoting. We are witnessing a paradigm shift in hip hop. And also, while I was doing my research, I found a lot of people comparing him to an artist named Vucci P. I'm on my way to the top and these niggas ain't knowing. I'm flying high with the pigeons and birds, I'm sorry. Okay, I definitely see the comparisons. I think the biggest difference is that you can actually hear what this guy is saying, and I think just the absolute ridiculousness of the 6:45 AR song is what, you know, gives it the appeal. But I did find out that Vucci has been doing this for over 2 years now. I got bitches on my iPhone. I got bitches on my iPhone. And I even saw people comparing it to Future. And Pharrell. The front row and it's time. New clock bag with the five. Yellow diamonds with the rainbow. But basically what these people are saying is that the whole squeak rap thing isn't new. However, if we look at Lil Nas X doing country rap, that wasn't really new either. There were multiple instances of rappers mixing country style lyrics or country style beats in with hip hop. And I've said this before and I'll say it again, it's not about who does it first, it's about who does it best. So Vucci P may have been doing it. Maybe Future stole from Vucci P, or maybe Pharrell stole from Vucci P, or maybe they didn't, or whatever. It doesn't really matter, because maybe it wasn't the right time or there wasn't the right marketing strategy. Who knows? Seems like people are buzzing over 6:45 AR, and now is the time because it's interesting. I have a feeling that 6:45 AR could make a really, really big song. Not gonna say that this music is for me or that I particularly like it. I respect it, but I'm not even gonna lie, while I was doing research on this video, I had a massive headache after because I just couldn't listen to those frequencies for a long period of time. It's more of like a novelty listen. I think if this came on at a party, I think it would get a lot of people hype and I would be hype, but after like two songs, I'd be like, okay, let's turn this off. But it's definitely weird, it's definitely original, and I feel like if he just gets the right combination of sauce, he can do some sort of Young Thug, Playboy Cardi type appeal where the song is not about the lyrical content or anything other than just the vibe or the way that it makes you feel. I do think that he will continue to grow. It's really tough for me to say like what I think will happen, because something just tells me that it can't work, because it's just so hard to listen to, like, over and over again. I don't think anybody could become, like, a huge 645 AR fan, right? Like, people pick a rapper and they become their biggest fan and listen to all their music. Just don't know if that can happen with him. But I do think he can continuously go viral. I think that he can make interesting music, and I'm definitely rooting for him. I like it. I respect it. I appreciate it. I like him trying to shake things up. I like how mad people are getting over it. I think overall, it's just fun. It's not really meant to be taken too seriously. So 645 AR, I'm wishing you the best of luck. Keep killing it. Shake the game up. Make people mad. And we'll see what happens in the future. My name is Patrick CC. I'm out.